Well, good evening and welcome along to the first Dundee Stars live show of the 23-24 season. I'm Stephen Swan, joined by the Director of Hockey Operations and Head Coach of the Dundee Stars. It is Mark Lefebvre. Mark, before we start anything, we'll just remind fans that they can submit questions for you this evening. It's open all doors, so send them in and we will squeeze as many of them in as possible. To ask a question, just use the Facebook chat or use the YouTube chat, and we'll get to them at the end of the conversation. So tonight we're going to go through the whole team. We're going to talk about those exciting games that we have coming up this weekend against Fife Flyers in our pre-season preparations. And we will also talk about pre-season camp so far this week. But Mark, firstly, I'll just ask you, how you doing?
I'm well, thank you. It's good to be back in Dundee and great to perform on the ice with all the guys again and in front of the fans.
Let's talk about Sunday. I know the fans were able to see that on the social media pages that it was induction day, but how real did things get for you on that day when you had the roster sitting in the locker room and giving them those season talks before even induction day started?
Well, it's one of the most exciting days of the season, obviously, that first day of camp and getting everybody together. Fortunately, we've had everybody here since day one, and all the players getting used to the city and the arena and our staff and how we run things, and it's been great to see.
Yeah, absolutely. And, I mean, that day was, for me, that was the day when it all started. I know we've talked about it already this season, or pre-season, you know, or when we've been doing recruitment, about everybody getting excited. But I don't know about you, it all got real for me on Sunday afternoon when everybody got together.
Yeah, I mean, those days, it's great to, for the players to introduce themselves to the staff and the backroom staff. And, you know, we're a small club and we need everybody helping out and helping each other out here and have success on the ice. So the players know that, you know, they got to know everybody and it's great to see.
Talking about preseason, it's only a few short days in, and we're going to get into each player individually as part of this show. But how impressed have you been as a group overall with things and those, I suppose, those preparations so far?
Well, so far so good. Obviously, it's early days, and the guys are getting their conditioning and getting used to each other, building that chemistry, getting our systems in place, and how we want to play, and just doing all the little things that takes in training camp to get ready for the season. So it's been good to see good off-ice sessions, good on-ice sessions here. But we're early days still.
We sure are. The DIA buzzing, though, and the box office has been very busy, isn't it, for these huge games coming up. You know, but yeah, let's, you know, we've got this massive weekend coming up against Fife Flyers. Are you just excited to get the puck dropped and start some pre-season preparations in terms of games and fans being there?
Well, it's great to play in full building. Obviously, we've gone through some years of the pandemic, and obviously we've shifted through that now and have full buildings again. And it's exciting to see for everybody. And, you know, get the players on the ice, get them in some game shape here, play some competitive games, especially against a good rival like Fife. And I'm sure their fans are going to be up for it. They're going to be up for it for as well. They've got a completely new lineup like as we do. And it's going to be a good challenge for us.
Yeah, we'll get into that a little bit more. But shall we go through the team you have put together through a lot of grueling hard work, Mark, and sleepless nights, days and all sorts. I was speaking to someone last week and, you know, I was actually saying that people don't realise, but there have been times when you've been sending messages when it's 2 a.m. your time or, you know, or all sorts of times throughout the night. I mean, it literally didn't stop to put this team together, did it? The hard work from everybody.
Well, it drives my partner nuts when I had to get up in the middle of the night to make a phone call or text somebody like that, give them some breaking news or anything like that, or get a deal done. But here we are. I think my first week in Dundee was probably the most boring week that I've had all summer, really, just because I had no agents to call, I had no players to call, really. And but it was just exciting to be back and get around the city again. But, you know, I'm glad we have a complete lineup and exciting to get everybody here together and looking forward to the games this weekend.
Yeah, you talk about the girl, but of course there's Oscar as well, right? And how does he react when you're up all hours, Mark, having to sign players? Does he think he's going for a walk?
He doesn't sleep. So, like, he has me up at 6 o'clock every morning, 6:30 the latest. So he's like a little alarm clock. So he runs the household, that's for sure.
That's it. Oscar is Mark's dog, if anyone's unaware. It's not a child, Mark, just in case people think you had a kid in the house as well. And we're breaking news tonight or something. But Right, well, we'll go through the roster and we'll start off with the goalies. And we're going to start off with number 37. That's Kevin Carr. A real signing. I had fans ecstatic, Mark, when he was announced. Not just here, but around the league as well. A lot of shock that you managed to pull in Kevin Carr for this season. But yeah, how has he settled in over the last few days, and how excited are you for him this season?
Well, I think he's settled in well. You can see by the first few practices, capabilities that he has as a goaltender. Obviously, he led the league in shutouts a couple of years ago. Now he's played a big club in Nottingham. He's played has good experience in the ECHL and obviously in Norway last season. He's pretty quiet in the room there, but when he speaks, the guys listen. And obviously, he's going to be a great number one goalie for us. And with all teams, if you want to have success, you have to have great goaltending.
And when you talk about him, Mark, you know, that leadership, he is a quiet guy. But we're even seeing in the press releases through the Stars website from Chris Smith this week, Lucas, who we'll get onto in a few moments, talking about even early on getting that them pointers, those tips from him and developing his game as well. And I suppose that leadership's something that you'll be looking forward to with him as the season goes on.
Well, he's a general back there, especially being the number one goalie. So he's got to lead by example, obviously. And, you know, he's going to bark orders to our defense and our forwards that are playing down low. So he's going to be controlling things quite well. Most of the phone calls I made this summer to all the players, you can joke around a little bit and talk to them about different things. But his was pretty straight down the line and narrow. And, you know, it was pretty professional phone call the whole way. And, you know, we want that. We want professional character in our dressing room. And he definitely brings that.
Absolutely. I think I can only echo the sentiments. I think when we did the interview with him, you know, afterwards, such a professional guy, you know, and he was only here to win championships, trophies and do something. And you can't go wrong with that, right, as the bringing in a goaltender like that. Let's talk about his, I don't like to say backup, but the number 44, Lucas Brown. What do you think he's going to bring to the Stars this season?
Well, right now, through the first few days of training, I think I've been really impressed with him. He's a lot better than I expected, and he's going to give us a chance when he gets in the net there. And, you know, he's going to bide his time. He's going to learn off Kevin. Obviously, he's going to get used to the pro game. But, you know, usually your backup goalies are usually your best guys. They're the big rah-rah guys in the dressing room and on the bench. So we need a little bit of that from him. But obviously, when he gets his opportunity, we need some stops as well. So when he's going to get a chance here to play. And, you know, he's a big body. He's got some great experience at different levels. And we look forward to developing him as well.
And does it impress you with him, Mark, that, you know, you're hearing comments like he's taking on that advice from Kevin Carr and he's wanting to develop his game. He's not here just to make up numbers. He wants to make this experience something where he's learning and to get ice time as well.
Well, I think the big problem right now in UK hockey, there's no really British depth in terms of goaltending. So we have to develop these guys and bring them through at some point. And he's going to get an opportunity here. So, like I said, he's going to learn off a great pro like Kevin, and he's going to get an opportunity.
The next player, let's talk about this. So talking of guys that brought excitement, we're moving now to the defense. Number 4, Sean Allen. What a signing you brought in here. I know you talked about how you brought this one in. Were you, did you know he was going to get that reaction from the Stars, but also the Elite League fans thinking, wow, how has Mark managed to pull this guy in?
Well, I know what gets our fans excited. Obviously, you know, when I was here before with Justin and Craig Sescon and those guys and what they bring to the table. And, you know, Sean can play as well, but he's going to keep guys honest. He's going to be a great player for us in the back end. He's fit, big, he's physical. He's a bit of an entertainer, but he can play as well. He can make a great first pass. He's a big body, he's big and physical, and just brings a lot to our table.
And the great thing about him when he was doing his interview and that, he was straight edge about it, wasn't he? He's here to stick up for his teammates and bring that physicality to your team. But also, he says to chip in, you know, on the other areas as well, and show his hockey qualities as well as just the fighting.
Yeah, gone are the days where you just have those one-dimensional players. So he's got to be able to play as well. And so far in the first few days of camp, he definitely shows that he can play. Like I said, he can move the puck well out of our zone to our forwards in the transition game. And he just brings that physicality to the back end. You know, we want to be a hard team to play against, especially in our own zone in front of Kevin and Lucas. And he definitely brings that.
And I suppose I would ask you how you're going to keep him away from Dops reviews. But is that something that you've considered and factored in this season?
We'll see how it goes. So I may have to make a few phone calls here and there, but you know, we know how it is. It's the same in every league. We're always going to complain about the referee, no matter what, whether you're a fan or a coach. So we'll see how things go, but we don't want to take away from his game. We want him to you know, stick up for his teammates, bring that physicality to our lineup and that character.
We'll look forward to those post-match interviews where you're talking about that kind of stuff, Mark. I suppose the next guy, let's talk about the guy that's in with the Stars for many years, in with the paintwork really, Dryden Dow, the number six. He's been at the club for a number of years now and a real integral part of everything, both on and off the ice. And I think you could see that on induction day as well, just how much experience he brings of what it is to be a Dundee Star. And I suppose in some ways those qualities to help those import players this season.
Yeah, he's been here for a few years now, and he's basically a Dundonian. And obviously, we want to make a lot of changes from last season, but there's probably only a couple guys I wanted to bring back import-wise, and he was definitely one of them. He was a leader of the team, and obviously, he was part of the group that got to the semifinals 2 years ago in Nottingham. And obviously, he's a great offensive defenseman, but he plays with a little bit of bite. Obviously, we've had some physicality in our practices the last few days, and he's not afraid to get stuck in, and he definitely brings that to the table. He brings a lot at both ends of the rink, but he's also a great leader off the ice as well. And he's going to be our captain again with the Stars here, and he's been leading from example since day one here. And you know, I think the guys rely on him a little bit to get to know Dundee, and he's definitely been great at it.
And it's no shock you say that. You know, I mean, you could see the leadership qualities in him just from every season we've been here, but for you certainly just since that induction day, I'm sure you've seen it as well, and it's I suppose a real asset to have someone of his quality who's embraced the city and the team and everything that goes with it along the way. But yeah, that's a great news for Stars fans to hear that this evening. I suppose the next player we'll talk about is Chris Ingalls. He's a guy that you developed in your first period here, Mark. Of course, he was up front for a little bit, but back to his defensive qualities now, and he's really turned into a solid homegrown player, as the league like to refer to him, but as a British player. And again, another local guy, it brings a lot of qualities.
Well, he's a big body. He brings that physicality on the back end that we're looking for. Obviously, he knows the league quite well. He's from Dundee. You know, we want him to bring that physicality to our back end as well. We want to be a big physical group back there in front of Kevin and Lucas, and he definitely brings that. And I know he's a fan favorite. He's not afraid to drop the gloves either and play with a little bit of bite. And, you know, he's a lot better shape as he is than he was when I was first here the first time. But, you know, I'm looking forward to working with him again.
Yeah, and exactly. And you're talking about that grit and, you know, British players really making a mark. This could be a big season for Chris Ingalls, can't it? If he really manages to develop that game even further than what he's done before and become a real staple in the elite league.
Yeah, we're going to be a much better team with him in the lineup. And he knows the guys around him that he's playing with. He's going to get another opportunity this season to play with an import to start with anyways. And then he's just got to take the ball and run with it and add that physicality to the back end and play his game and stick up for his teammates, move the puck to our forwards and just play a solid all-around game.
Well, let's talk of the last addition, I think. Number 23, Kyle Pouncey. How's he settled in over the last few days? And what have you thought so far, Mark?
He's quiet. He comes as advertised. He moves the puck well. He's a big body back there, a right-handed guy that we were looking for. Nothing sexy about his game. He just gets the job done, and that's what we were looking for in our last signing on the back end. And you know, great human being as well, and nothing but kindness from that guy. And obviously, he works hard in practice so far, what I've seen. But he brings a lot to the table. And like I said, I think earlier when we signed him, you don't notice him, but you'll notice him when he's not in the lineup, and definitely brings a lot to the table there.
Yeah, 100%. And fans are probably more buzzing about his signing, you know, as exactly what you've sold him as on those interviews when you signed him, and as he did as well. He knows exactly what his game is, and he knows the qualities he brings, and he is that guy that when he's missing, you notice he's gone, but he ain't going to do any flashy, fancy stuff. However, there's always this season to change that a bit, Mark. You never know.
I wasn't signing a sexy defenseman, so it's you know, he just brings a very simple game and a very simple play to our defensive end, and I'm looking forward to working with him, and so far so good.
Number 55 next, Chris McKay.
Another big body. Obviously, we want a big back end. He's won a championship in the East Coast Hockey League before, so he brings that championship pedigree to our lineup. He can get up and down in the play there. He's just a big, solid defenseman on the back end, long reach. He knows how to shut down plays in our zone. He's got some physicality to him. He's not afraid to stick up for his teammates either. So, you know, you see the common theme with our defenseman for the most part, just big bodies back there. And, you know, again, nice human being, great for our locker room, and he brings a lot to the table.
And fans keep on hearing it, physicality, Mark, but how important is that in an elite league team that's going to be successful these days to have those big bodies, that physical presence in order to win games?
Well, we want to take away time and space from the other teams. And, you know, we want to make Kevin and Lucas's job a lot easier. We want to clean up those rebounds in front of the net, you know, box guys out the net front. And you need some big, heavy bodies back there that we have. And guys who are physical and stand up for our teammates, you know, anybody touching our goalies, they're going to pay the price for it. And we definitely have the guys to do that.
Certainly delivering the newspaper headlines there, Mark. Pay the price. I like it. 65, Craig Moore, a guy who has had a, you know, been around the league now. He knows the league really, really well. A guy you brought in and developed, Mark, and I suppose set him on his career and path. Just how impressed are you with him in terms of the first few days? And I suppose it's someone, again, who you've known from before. How do you think he's developed even off the ice as a person?
Well, I think the big thing for him, he brings a lot of speed to our back end. I think he's just got to play with confidence, and he definitely has shown a lot more ability than he did in the first couple of years when I was here, but he was great for us back then. And, you know, I think, like I said just a few seconds ago, he's just got to play with some confidence. And I think once he has all that, he'll definitely be a great player for us and a lot of capability, and he just got to go and play his game.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, if he stays fit this year, do you think this is a big year for Craig Moore in terms of the Elite League, Mark?
Oh, it's massive. I think playing the defenseman that we have him with, and this is the overall team, and buying into our concept and how we want to play. He's played for me before, so he knows what to expect and what my expectations are of him. And he's just got to come every day, put his shift in, and you know, develop under that.
Let's get in now to number 8, Spencer Nass. What does he bring?
He's just a versatile forward. He's a two-way player. He can play center. He can play wing. I coached against him 2 years ago in France, so I definitely know what he brings to our team and our lineup. And again, he's got some offensive capabilities, got a lot of experience either playing the American League or the ECHL. Now he's played in Europe a little bit, so he just brings a little bit of everything. Again, nothing sexy to his game, but he's a great two-way forward. He can play in all situations for us, and you know, he's got that experience as well. He's an older guy in our lineup, and you know, we're just looking for that two-way versatility from him.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, that was a signing that people were really, really excited about when he signed. And I suppose it's a big season here for him. And, you know, how is he settled in the first few days, would you say, Mark?
I think great. He brings a lot of speed to our lineup up front there. And you see on the clips right now. And, you know, in practice, he pushes the pace there. He's a great, like I said, he's a great two-way player. And you notice that in practice right away.
Yeah. Next player in the lineup, number 9, Ryan Valentini.
Speed, skill, he has it all. Obviously, I think he's going to be a top guy for us, and he definitely has offensive capabilities. You know, he can get up the ice quickly. He can turn guys inside out. He's got a great shot. You know, he's going to bring a lot of offense that we need to our lineup, especially on the power play and in, you know, situations where we need goals. He's just a great all-around offensive player.
Yeah, and he's one that just excites me because I think he's one of those players that, you know, is going to be really successful in the Elite League. You can just see from these highlights, I just think this league's going to be perfect for him. I suppose it's exciting times for the fans to be able to have him in a Stars shirt this year and see what he can do.
Yeah, he's just got to bring that speed and that skill to our lineup every night. And obviously, we're going to rely on him quite a bit up front. And, you know, but he's got to play a responsible two-game as well. He's got to buy into the team concept, which he definitely does. And but we want to let him off the leash as well and let him go to town in the offensive zone.
Yeah, and that's going to be exciting times for fans when they hear that. The next guy we'll go through, number 12, Jonathan McBean. A lot of fans refer to him and think he's going to be a John Dolan-type figure in the years to come for the Dundee Stars and have that presence. A lot of pressure on him when he's linked with names who were as integral to the Stars as that. But what do you think he's going to do this year? Is this a big season for him?
Well, yeah, especially in his development. You look at the guys that he's going to be surrounded with that bring that, you know, pro experience. He's going to learn a lot off those guys. And obviously, through the first few days of training, he brings a lot of speed, brings a lot of skill that I really noticed. And I've been really impressed with him the last few days. Obviously, he has a lot to learn about the pro game, especially in his own end. But he's going to develop well. I think he's the future of the Stars and I think a future guy for GB as well.
Yeah, does it excite you, Mark, to be able to work with players like that and develop their game? We know you've done it before with the likes of Mersey, with the likes of Ingles in his early tenure. Is that the kind of thing you enjoy as a coach?
Yeah, I like developing players. I think right now there's just so much of a gap between the last guys that have come through and with the Stars and through Dundee in general and the new guys coming through now. I think we got to bridge that gap somehow and keep developing players at a younger age and give them opportunities. And Johnny's definitely getting that right now with us.
The next guy, number 14, James Phelan. What do you think he's going to bring to the Dundee Stars this year?
Speed, skill, and physicality. Again, he's a good two-way player. He's a little bit more physical than Spencer Noss is. And again, he's a pain in the ass to play against. Gets in guys' faces. He's got that skill set with him as well and some speed. So, he's another great two-way player for us that adds some physicality up front. And obviously that experience that he's brought from playing the American League. He's played at a really good program at the University of New Brunswick for a couple seasons. And obviously he's got experience last year in the East Coast Hockey League. And overall, he's got a great shot. If you watch him in practice the last few days, he's got a tremendous shot.
He sure has. And it's the kind of player, isn't it, Mark, with that physicality that the so-called bigger teams in the league would go for. And I think that's what excites me from watching those early training clips of him and these highlights here is that he has got that physical presence up front, but also the quality to score with it as well.
Yeah, he's not going to back down from anybody. He's going to go to the hard areas to try and score goals and create plays. And that's what we need overall as a team. We got to get to those dirty areas. I think we're not going to be a sexy team to watch, but we're going to grind teams down and get to those hard areas and be tough to play against.
Let's talk about number 15, Craig Garrigan. He is the guy that we always go to for all our promotional material, Mark, right at the end of the season. And he always says yes. But this guy is another Dryden Dow, Chris Ingles type of guy. He's in there now with, in terms of the paintwork and the structure of the Dundee Stars. But how are you expecting him to develop his game this season?
Well, again, he's going to get an opportunity like Johnny is and Chris and Craig and Lucas are going to get an opportunity to play some good pros and develop that way. Obviously, he's in his mid-20s right now. And, we want to bring an offensive side to his game. Obviously, he's a guy who gets in guys' faces and finishes his checks and he'll put a shift in. We don't have to worry about that part of it. But we want him to bring a little bit more offense to our lineup and obviously be a responsible player in the other side of the puck as well. So I'm looking forward to working with him. So far, so good. And you see in the training session that he is going to put a shift in every time he's on the ice. So it's a benefit to us.
Yeah, let's talk about the great Rinaldi now. That's Anthony Rinaldi, number 17. Just how has he settled in over the last few days and what have you thought of him so far?
I like the speed. I like the skill. I knew that coming in. I coached against him last year in France. And, he's got that, again, a little bit of American League experience. And he's got some East Coast League experience. Obviously, did well there. And he's a very quiet, mild-mannered guy. So, again, I think he's going to be one of those guys. If he's on the lineup, you're going to notice it. And but, again, he's got that speed. He's got that skill. He's definitely going to benefit their offensive side of the puck.
Yeah, he sure is. Even I think I was Oscar barking in the background. He's excited by Rinaldi signing as well.
Yeah, you just saw a highlight there, so we got a little bark in there. So with that, I think he's settled in now. But Anthony so far is so good with him. He's a good guy. Obviously, I'm looking forward to watching him and everybody else in the game, especially this weekend.
Yeah, absolutely. And I just like the fact that Oscar barked. Just as you said, he was a quiet guy, but an all-rounded guy. Just at that point, it was like it was timed. And perfect. But yeah, he is somebody that everyone's going to look very much forward to seeing this weekend as the Stars face the Fife Flyers. Number 18 for the Dundee Stars is Carter Johnson. How impressed have you been with him so far, Mark, in his early days of training and I suppose off ice?
Off the ice, he's a great human being, very well-mannered, nice guy. And then on the ice, he definitely brings a skill set to us. He's another guy who could play center and wing. So that brings that versatility that we want throughout our lineup. And I think he's going to be a great offensive addition to us. And also, playing a responsible game in the defensive zone as well. But I think right there, you see he's got a big body. He can bring pucks to the net there. And he's going to be tough to play against down low.
Yeah, and having that versatility is an important thing, isn't it? As the season goes on, and you're trying to adapt games, I suppose, change games and injuries and all sorts come in. It's good to have guys that are versatile like that.
Yeah, you want to be deep at center. So we got lots of guys who've played traditionally center in the past that can also play wing. So if we ever need something in a pinch, we got suspension, got kicked out of a game, some injuries, We got a lot of guys that can move to middle ice there. And, you know, Carter's get back to, he's a big body there that can play hard down low and bring pucks to the net. So, and that's kind of team we want to be.
We'll go through to number 22, Josh Britton. He's a guy that everyone knows in the Elite League from last season, but I suppose he'll have a point to prove this season and want to have a very good season at the Dundee Stars.
Yeah, big body, brings pucks to the net, you know, hard to play against down low. He's a great player in the back end as well in the defensive zone. But big thing for me is puck possession and winning faceoffs. He definitely does that. He's one of the top faceoff guys in the league last season. And obviously his experience, you know, it's just rubbing off guys in the room as well. And, you know, he's been around quite a bit. He's been in Europe a long time, played the American League, played in the East Coast. He's an NHL draft pick. And he just brings a lot to our dressing room and on the ice as well. And again, he's another versatile guy, can play all over the ice.
Yeah, and exactly. And he's got that experience of being in that big weekend, which is what we're searching to be in at the end of the season, right? And I suppose he'll have a point to prove in that as well and want to win it this time rather than just be there.
Yeah, 100%. I mean, that's why we're playing, right? We want to win trophies this season and get to know him and win a playoff championship. And he definitely has that pedigree with him, playing in the last season with Carter, so he knows what to expect.
And this guy, next one on the list, is one that excites me, Mark. I think he's going to be a real star in the Elite League. Number 39, Tommy Paratino. I think he is absolutely, I just think he's set up for excitement in this league and doing well. But how are you excited about him, and how has he settled in?
Again, another guy who's settled in well so far in the first few days of training. He's got a great shot. You know, 23 goals as a rookie last year in the East Coast Hockey League. And, you know, coming off the wing, either on the strong side or the weak side, he's got a guy who knows how to pick corners and that. And so far in training, you can see that. And, you know, again, overall, his whole game is offense, obviously. We need that to win hockey games. And definitely on the power play, he's going to be an asset.
He sure is. I mean, it's just that it's a signing, I think, that the fans got really excited about. And the Stars are the team that normally bring players in who no one knows of, you know, and then they make a real mark in the league and with the Dundee Stars. And I just feel like this guy, not putting pressure on him, could be one of those guys for us this season.
Oh, he could be an unsung hero. We need those type of guys. Obviously, he's going to score big goals for us this season. And obviously, he's going to be an offensive catalyst, you know, just driving the play, especially with his shot off the wing and driving the net.
Talking of guys who are going to be big-time players and be influential, number 56, Johnny Walker. Everybody was excited when you signed this guy, and we're still excited. But yeah, how have you found him so far?
Comes as advertised. He's definitely a character off the ice, on the ice. He keeps things interesting, that's for sure. And, you know, he's loved by the guys, obviously, already. And I know the fans will love him as well. He just plays a hard-nosed hockey game. He goes to net. He's got a good skill set on him. He can play both ends of the rink. He's physical. You know, he just brings so many things to our hockey club. And, you know, just not on the ice, but off the ice as well. And he's definitely going to be a fan favorite.
He sure is. I can't wait to see him do some of this stuff, hopefully against Fife on the weekend, you know, but absolutely. Yeah. Buzzing. I know the fans just, it's one name. It keeps on popping back up with fans when you see them around the arena and in the city, they keep on talking about the excitement of seeing Johnny play for the Stars. And as you say, a real character already, as well as an outstanding hockey player. So exciting times ahead with him. 81, Brendan Harms is the next guy on our list. Another one, Mark, that excites me. I think is going to have an interesting season.
Just a hard-nosed two-way player. I know I've been after him for a few seasons now. My GMs, for some reason, on my other clubs, didn't want to sign him. I just think he brings so much to our lineup, on the ice, off the ice. He's a real pro. You know, he's played over in Europe now for a number of years. Good experience. Hard to play against, especially down low. He's great in his own zone. And I think he's going to score some big goals for us and make some big plays at the other end of the rink in the defensive zone as well.
Yeah, I think that your other GMs are going to regret not listening to you and signing him after the season he's going to have at the Stars this year. And let's talk about the guy that really threw everybody off guard when you announced the signing of number 98, Jake Elmer, for the season. Of course, and making that move swiftly for him when he became available, Mark.
Yeah, we were looking at different options for a last player. And obviously, I always want to add a little bit more offense to our game. I think we have the physicality and a hard team to play against, especially down low, in the trenches. And we wanted some more offense, a guy who's going to help our power play. And this guy's definitely going to do that. And you see in practice, he's got a great shot. He's got great experience. He got a taste of Europe last season in Slovakia, started the year here in Denmark. So he's used to it by now, but you look at his pedigree, guy can definitely shoot the puck and score some big goals.
Yeah, you just see it there, don't you? It's that energy and that ability to do that. And it's just exciting to have a player like that in our blue jersey this season and being part of this team. And it must have been, how did it feel, Mark, when you were able to get one like that over the line?
Well, he's definitely the player that we were looking for, or a type of player we were. And when he became available, we jumped on it right away. And, looking at his background, I know a lot of guys have played with him in the past, either in the American League or in the Coast. And I know, obviously, he started the year in Odense, where I was for 2 years. So I know the management there. And, it's all good things to say. Everybody, you want an offensive guy, that's your guy. And he definitely brings that to the table.
Remember and squeeze your questions in, guys, for Mark. We'll be taking them in just a few short minutes. You could do it using the live chat option on YouTube or the Facebook chat and get them in. Mark's not shy. I'm sure he'll answer your question and be happy to do so. Mark, you've seen these guys on the ice for a couple of days now. You know, we've talked about them there individually in terms of qualities. I think something that coaches always say is you don't really know what you've got until you see it in practice and, and on the ice. And I know it's only 2 days in, but just how excited are you about this roster overall? And exactly what do you think it's going to be able to bring to the city this year?
Well, I think we're going to be a hard-nosed, the physical team. That's an exciting team. You saw the clips of the guys there. They're excited when they score goals. And obviously, we score a lot of them this season. But like I said, we wanted a hard-nosed team to play against, especially in our own zone. And, we don't need killers. But it's just got to be a hard physical team, get the puck out with first chance, transition onto the offense and go play in the other team's zone. We want to make Kevin and Lucas's life a lot easier. And that's why we've got some big bodies that can play hard down low. We got responsible guys up front that can play a solid two-way game. So, we have a little bit of everything. Are we the sexiest lineup in the league? Probably not. But we're just the way training has been going the last few days. You can see the work ethic, the physicality, the skill set on guys, and it's going to be exciting when the games start this weekend.
And how did it feel for you personally being back? I know you've been back now for a bit of time at the club, but to actually step back in the rink and be taking part in a training session again, did it feel like you've never been away, or did it feel slightly different?
No, to be honest, I feel like coming home, and I know I keep saying that to people, but it's actually true. I mean, I took a little walk around the Overgate the first Saturday I was back, and the interesting characters were still hanging out there, so I knew I was back in Dundee then. So it was a nice welcoming back. But, not much in the city has changed. Obviously, some things have been added to it, some things have left. But, again, it feels like I've never left. Obviously, my relationship with the Wards and obviously seeing Kevin and that back down at the rank and all the staff there, Neil and everybody, and it's been great to be back.
Yeah, I mean, you talk about Kitka. Of course, everyone at the Stars knows him. Many don't understand him, but he's like a heart and soul of that locker room, really, isn't he, in that backroom team, Mark?
He's something else, that's for sure. But he's always got a smile on his face. He's never angry or upset about anything. So he brightens up your day, that's for sure.
Yeah, he does. And I know they don't want to shout out Mark, but I know we've had a lot of off-season work going on in the background. So shout out to Jack, Struan, Chris, Wayne, and everybody else who's put a lot of effort into stuff and in order to get us to this point, because it all adds, I think, to the excitement for the season and the way the fans are feeling about everything that's coming up. So yeah, shout out to them and your backroom team as well, who I know put an incredible amount of work in before you even get here to prepare, make sure everything was right for this upcoming season.
Yeah, I mean, they're the blood and the backbone of the hockey club. You need people like that who are willing to put the time in, whether it's on the media side, the athletic therapy side, like Early does, Kit Kat, obviously, and Brian. Brian's been a great addition as well. It's been helping out Kit Kat. Everybody around the club, Dr. Linda. I got Daryl's coming back to help us out a little bit too. So it's it's great. Everybody's got to help each other out. You know, like I said, we're not the biggest club in the world, so we don't have 50 employees or and ticket staff and all that kind of thing. So everybody around the rink of the DIA and obviously all those staff, that, like yourself, Swanee and Wayne and everybody and young Michael. And, you know, it's great to have everybody on board, and it's exciting things coming up for the club.
Yeah, shout out to Darryl, by the way. I was amazed how he knows he's Canadian and British laws all at the same time, Mark. I was quite impressed with that, how he can interlink them on the weekend. I was very impressed with how he's got a raft of knowledge for both countries, right? It's like an encyclopedia, if you want any information off him. So, yeah, I think we need to give him a shout out for that. I was impressed how he was able to do that. Let's go to fans' questions. Shall we start off, Mark? And if there's anything in there that you don't want to answer, then I'm sure you'll quite clearly say, but I think we should be okay.
It's live, so we can't really edit this, so it's fine.
I forgot. Fine, right? There's no 20 outtakes, right? So we're just going to have to just answer it anyway. Right, here we go. Here's the first one coming up. What is your aim of the season, Mark?
Well, the first aim is for us to make it to that top eight. And then obviously we see what happens. You know, like when I was here my second year, we beat out Glasgow or Brayhead at the time. We got to that semifinal weekend. And obviously 2 years ago with Pasha's team, you got to the final four in Nottingham as well. So anything can happen. You just get, for one, we got to get into that top eight. And then, you know, get hot for 2 weekends and you're playoff champions. And I know it's a league structure. I know it's a league format that everybody wants to win, but you know, in the hockey world, it's about playoffs, and that's what we're aiming for.
Absolutely. The next question is favorite signing.
Ask me at the end of the season. That will probably bear time to ask me that.
Good answer. This one, how do you play on the ice? E.g., do you want to play defensive or attacking or just keep the puck?
Well, I think it's a possession game now. I think, you know, you want to keep the puck. So not to give too much away, but in the offensive zone, you want to play those five-man rotations. You need your defense to be part of the attack now. Obviously, we want to keep teams to the outside in a defensive zone. We don't want to give too much in the slot. Like I've been saying, we want to make Kevin and Lucas's life a lot easier. So we've got to be tough in front of our net and keep things to the outside. And obviously, we want to play with a lot of speed coming out into the neutral zone, into the offensive zone. So there's a little bit there. Obviously, I love to have the puck for 60 minutes, but you can't. So you always have to have plans, you know, plan A, B, C. I think one thing I've learned over the years is sometimes as a coach, you get too wrapped up on what the other team's doing in your pre-scouts and you forget what your plan of attack is. So I think that's one thing I've gotten better as a coach is just sticking to our plan instead of adjusting all the time to the other teams, make the other teams adjust to us.
Absolutely. Next question is, hi guys, Mark, do we have an update on captains for this year? Well, you announced it, didn't you, I suppose, in terms of the captain, but not the rest.
Yeah, Dryden's going to be our captain again in the next few days. I think we're going to announce the assistants. Obviously, I've already chosen those. But Dryden has already been told that he's going to be captain. He knows that. So I think he's going to return as that.
Welcome back home, Mark. Good to have you back. That's from Graham McKenzie.
Thank you.
And Cody Bryson says, can't wait to see Dundee Stars and Fife Flyers on Sunday. Just how excited are you about that, Mark, and the return of those games? And of course, the other one with the other nasty rivals of Glasgow Clan.
Well, I think the Fife, they're like us, right? They've changed everybody around. They got a new coach in place there. They have a whole new rack of imports for the most part. So there's going to be a lot of changes to their team. Obviously, it's a huge rival for us, and we want to win those games, whether it's preseason, cup games, or regular season, or in the playoffs, so we have to play them. Obviously, Glasgow, everybody hates. They're the most hated club, I think, in Scotland. But, you know, every game counts for us, no matter what, who we're playing. But obviously, the rivalry ones are huge for our fans, and we want to win those especially.
Absolutely. I agree with all your sentiments. Hazel Grace says, can't wait to see Kevin Carr in action.
Yeah, me too. So I think after seeing him practice the last few days, you know, I could tell why we got him and why we signed him. Obviously, he's a guy who can keep guys accountable, obviously, on the ice and in the room. And like I said earlier, he can be a general for our defense back there.
Hamish Izzard says, welcome back, Mark Lefebvre. We are very happy and proud to have you back on board. Very impressed with your work and quality of players you've brought in. So one of many happy fans.
I appreciate that. Thank you.
Valerie Williams says, very excited about this season. Really impressed by Mark's coaching. Maybe need a swear box though. Yeah, Mark, that and maybe some extra tactics boards, maybe a couple of, I don't know, ice bench doors, all sorts of things we're needing in place, right, for you.
Yeah, I got a bit of a foul mouth, and especially on the ice in the dress room. So I try to keep it limited to there. My partner's got a swear jar on our counter back home in Florida. So it's I got to pay $5 into it every time I swear, because I'll be watching something or and I'll just drop an F-bomb or something like that. And there's $5 in the jar. So, but I'm trying to work on it, but I don't think at 41 it's gonna change it anytime soon.
Did you ever pay for Edinburgh for that bench door that you broke all those years ago?
No, I didn't. I forgot all about that. But no, that's I think they're still using the same one. I think they just duct taped it together. So no, I never paid for that. No. Don't tell Scott Neal, because he'll probably send the wards a nice bill, or myself. So
that's it. You're going to get it now. He's been duct taping it for 5 years. The duct tape is going to be included. But yeah, top five.
You know what? Hollis can pay for that, because he was so bad that game, but in my opinion, so he can pay for it, right?
The book of Pavel's penalties. Anyway, top five finish. What is the target, Mark, this season? Is it a top five finish? Is it more? What are you looking for?
Well, I you know, we want to win every game, right? We want to win every trophy that we're competing for. But like I said earlier, I think the goal really is, let's get into that top eight and have a great playoff run and then win a playoff championship. Obviously, the cup's important as well. We want to do well in that. I think getting to that top eight in the cup is really a good dress rehearsal for our guys who haven't played in the league before, to see what the playoff format is like. And then obviously a top eight finish into the Challenge Cup, and that prepares us for how the playoffs are going to work.
Absolutely exciting to hear that. Karen Midler says, this season is going to be awesome. I agree with her. What do you reckon?
Fingers crossed, it all goes well. But no, I'm, like I said, I'm excited to get this team into games this week, and I think it's going to be a great season.
Andrew Strange says, do you feel you have unfinished business here in Dundee, Mark, given you made the quarterfinals, then on to the finals weekend the year after?
Well, I think when you never won a championship with a club, I think that you always have unfinished business. I think just the way it ended last time I was here, we got to the semifinals and everything afterwards when I left, and obviously I'm coming back, and obviously it is unfinished business. We haven't won a trophy yet since I've been here, or when I was here last time, and now I'm back. So obviously it is unfinished business.
Yeah, good question, Andrew. Next one's from Craig Nishi. Says, been a long time without a major trophy. This ambition and the players we have on paper is exciting. Roll on the weekend.
Yeah, we don't want to make up the numbers in the league. I think it's such I'm going to swear now, I think it's bullshit if we're just going to, you know, play to play. I think we have to compete for something. And, you know, as competitive and as athletes and professionals, we want to be trying to play for something. And the guys know the goal. Guys are here to win. We want to win every game and everything we play for. So the guys are excited, and we hopefully be coming through with that.
You better put £5 in the new tip jar, yeah. Mark, or the spare jar.
It's got to be dollars, though, because it's the pound's worth a lot more than the US dollars. So.
Nah, well, you'll just have to pay the increase. I'm sure you'll manage. Nicky Nelson says, good luck for the season ahead. My husband played with you at Edinburgh in the BNL, and he still has one of your sticks.
I played with Edinburgh in the Elite League. So, yeah, I don't know what to say. If he has one of my sticks, great. I don't know if it's a collector's item. I don't think it's worth much. Maybe a tenner or so, but that's about it. But, no, it's cool to have some memorabilia.
The next one, Dunk Canio says, has the league brought in any rule changes for this season, I suppose, that you can make the fans aware of, Mark?
Nothing too crazy, I don't think. I think we're just following the IIHF rule book for the most part. And I mean, obviously the rules are same. Obviously, DOPS is a totally different thing than what the IIHF does. So on their rulings, I don't think if that's changed or not. Obviously, hopefully we don't get any suspensions or we have to face DOPS. But I think the standard of the league rules are pretty much the same.
And the next one, what are you doing to improve on-ice communication and off-ice team building?
The big thing for me is communication. We always preach it, especially in our defensive zone. You know, we want to be talking all the time. So we need all six guys in the zone, from the goalies to the D to the forwards and vice versa. So communicate, it's got to be talking all the time. on the bench myself to the guys, I have to be communicating at all times, you know, what we want, who's up next. It's just constant all the time. So it's not so much improving it. It's just doing it. And always talking, always in communication. Whether it's to correct something, like I said, or we're going to make an adjustment here and there or there. Who's up next? You know, different things go into that communication. So but it's going to be constant. Sometimes it's going to be barking at the referee once in a while, barking at the guys. That's part of it. And then off ice team building, the guys have been getting together and doing stuff. And, you know, Airlie's been putting them through the paces, obviously in the gym and doing other activities and that. So, that's her department really do all the off ice stuff. And, you know, the guys have been doing it every day.
Yeah. Exciting. Richie Millen says, welcome home.
Thank you. It's good to be back.
And Ryan Buchanan with a second question. Can you promise we will see Sean Allen fighting on Sunday night?
I can't make any promises. As long as we win the game and he's smart about things. But hey, if it happens, it happens. He's definitely got the green light to go if he has to go.
The next one's from Fraser Dukers. He says, hopefully Mark has some nice suits picked out this year. That's a good one.
I have a couple tailors now that do them for me. So I got a guy in Cincinnati that did a couple of suits for me, Philip Haas. He's awesome. And then I have a guy in London now. Started doing some suits for me last year. Arshad Apsley Taylors in London. So a few new ones since the last time I was here. And, you know, I'm looking forward to wearing them, I guess. But it's I'd rather people focus on the things on the ice instead of what I'm wearing. So.
After what you've said about Glasgow, I'm sure they'll be hammering you about your suits, Mark. Ewan says, Bolts or Panthers?
Oh, well, I live in Orlando, so it's about 45 minutes from Tampa. But, you know, I like the way that Florida played this year as well. I mean, obviously, Tampa had a great run for a few years there. And then obviously, Florida had a great run to the Stanley Cup Finals this year, and they got a great team. So I'm not a fan of anybody of either of those teams. It's more of a fan of good hockey, and they both play great hockey that, you know, I can learn a lot from that coaching staff and how they play that we can bring to our game.
And I think we've got one final question we'll squeeze in before we wrap up things, because that's been 50 minutes. From Callum Wilkie, he says, have you explained to the new guys what Fife's rink is like, or are you letting them experience it for themselves?
Well, I think Dryden and the guys who've been here before, and Josh has played in the league before, have kind of explained all the rinks to the guys. And I think the guys, when they're told about Manchester's rink, I think they kind of like, oh. But it is what it is. You can only play in the rinks that's in front of you or that you're on. And I mean, the atmosphere in Fife, it's always something else. But I know in that corner there where the Dundee fans are, I think they're still there. They'll probably be louder than the Fife fans as usual. So looking forward to seeing everybody there on Saturday.
Yeah, well, we are as well. It'll be great Saturday and Sunday, of course, in the Dundee Ice Arena, where you can see your trademark Dundee Stars for the first time this season in preseason action. I want to thank everybody for tuning in this evening and also providing all those questions. I love when we can do a live show, Mark, and add that element in. And I was a bit worried because me and you do take 20 takes usually for all our recordings, but this one's been quite smooth and worked all right.
No, it's been great. Like I said, it's great to be back in Dundee and seeing a lot of familiar faces. I'm looking forward to meeting the new supporters. That I got to give, you know, a shout out to Pash, because, you know, after I left, Pash did a great job on the business side of getting new supporters, new sponsors in. And it looks like we've maintained a lot of that. You know, young Michael's done a great job in maintaining those, you know, supporters and sponsors. And, you know, so I'm just looking forward to having everybody down the DIA on Sunday and cheering us on.
Yeah, sure is a legend, and I think it goes unnoticed sometimes how much work went into that. And all credit to the fans who have continued to stick by the team since the Omar Pasha days. And I think this is the most excited I've ever seen a fan base for an opening season at the Stars. So no pressure on you or the players, Mark, at all. Listen, thank you very much, everybody, for watching. If you haven't got tickets for the weekend's game, at home, you can get tickets by visiting dundeestars.com, and there's season ticket information and all sorts on there as well. Thank you very much to everybody for all their support over the closed season. And we're well and truly underway now, Mark, and business is about to pick up on the weekend. And well, good luck.
Perfect. Thank you.